Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hello, color-loving Illustrator people. In this video, we're gonna take our whale and we're gonna recolor him a couple of different options. Super quick, super easy using the Recolor Artwork option in Adobe Illustrator. Let's go and learn how to use that now. All right, so first thing to do is open up Recolor Artwork from your exercise files. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. We're gonna grab our artboard tool. The shortcut is Shift O. It's a weird one, but I use it all the time, Shift O. Okay, and we're gonna make a duplicate. Easiest way to make a duplicate is holding down the Alt key on a PC, or Option key on a Mac. We use this for like duplicating shapes. You can do the same, but you gotta drag the actual name. That's the best bit. Drag the name, artboard one. Okay, and we're gonna have a second color option. Cool. With my black arrow, I'm gonna select all the colors that I want to adjust. Basically, there's only kind of like two things, right? There's two kind of gradients that I've got. And I've locked the background here. So I've got them both selected and Command H, remember, kind of gets rid of all the blue lines. I do that when I'm recoloring. It's Control H on a PC, just to kind of make it look nice. Make sure to turn it back on, you'll get lost. With it selected, over here, there's one called Recolor. Make sure on your properties panel, click on Recolor. And to manually adjust them, like I've kept this quite simple. There's only four colors going on. That's either side of both of these gradients. You might have a lot more here. So to manually go and change, you might go and actually, instead of having to reach through the whole document and find all the instances, you can just go double click this guy. Okay, so that's my current color. And this is what I'm gonna switch it to. You just double click that swatch and you can go into here and say, actually, I wanna switch that out for pink. Okay, click OK, and you can see it's gone through and switched every instance of that for the pink. And you can do that for all of them. And there's this guy as well. He's gonna go from pink to, ooh, I'm gonna make it look ugly. I know I am. You know it's gonna happen. It's not, oh man. Okay, but you get what I mean, right? So you can manually go through and double click these to change it. Let's click OK, and let's look at it a different way. I'm gonna grab my artboard. Remember, Shift Zero. No, it's Shift O, not zero. Hold down the Alt key or the Option key, black arrow, which is the V key. Select all of this, we're gonna go to Recolor, and what we'll do is, actually what I might do is duplicate the first one before I made it real naff. Okay, so this guy I want a second copy of. And while we're here, we're gonna do another one after this. So we'll have four in total. All right, so I'm gonna select this guy and I'm gonna go to Recolor. And one of the other interesting options is the random one. So all this is gonna do is grab, you've got four colors and we've used them in a specific way. It's gonna go, it's this little icon here, random. Just goes randomly changes them, just moves them all around the place. Okay, so it's just a nice kind of way, I guess, of if you've got maybe gradients is not working as well, but maybe you've used five color swatches and you just wanna kind of go through and just, you know, see what a different kind of mixture might be. So you can click on random. Cool. Let's look at this last one here and probably the most important. I saved it to the last. Okay, is recolor. And what we want to do now is go to edit because assign is what it is by default. Let's click on edit and you get this color wheel. And there's two ways of doing it. You can just kind of drag them around by themselves because these are the colors, right? That's the kind of red that I'm using. These are the two greens and this was the kind of yellowy thing that I was using. And you can just move them around, okay? It's dragging them. It's not much different, I guess, than that first option where we double click them. Where it gets really cool is if you link them all. So when you change this one, they all change, okay? And it kind of gives you a way of kind of recoloring the whole thing at once. And they keep the kind of balance of of gradient, initial gradient color selection. Okay, and the color wheel moves around. Am I making this better? I'm not sure. Wow. I'm gonna leave it there, click okay. What I'd like you to do as a class project is to go through and come up with your own color options, maybe make a few of them, take a screenshot, send them to me on Instagram or on Twitter. I am at bringyourownlaptop on Instagram and I'm at Dan Loves Adobe on Twitter. Of course, post them on the website here as a class project. Yeah, I'd love to see what you come up with. You don't have to use gradients. You can switch those out first. Yeah, let's get on to the next video. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something. Don't be shy. I'd love to see what it is. If you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, for you to mention me. I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram. And on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.